Inside this magic toolbox, I have the top 40 tools you'll need for your 3D printing journey, and I'll review them with you in less than 20 minutes. Hi, I'm Ken of Rist Innovations, and I scoured the YouTube universe for all the recommended tools for 3D printing, and I have chosen the top 40 tools that you will need to have the greatest success. I spent hours reviewing tool recommendations, and I purchased several of the tools I didn't previously own, so I could perform my own testing on their usefulness. I relied on my 40 years of experience with my own workshop, as well as my mechanical engineering degree. So let's get started. I separated the tools into the following categories. Number one, assembly and disassembly. Number two, first layer adhesion. Number three, general. Number four, maintenance. Number five, measurement. And number six, post-processing. Some of these tools fit into multiple categories, and the list is not in any particular order of importance. Links for all the tools are in the description below. The first category is assembly/disassembly. Number one on the list, hex ball end screwdriver set, both metric and imperial. The hex ball end screwdrivers are much easier to use than the vertical Allen wrenches that come with the 3D printers. They are much faster and they are much more comfortable to use, and they can reach difficult areas. To tighten down even more securely, I use these T-handled set of Allen wrenches. Number two, flat flush cutters. These flush cutters are great for cutting zip ties, filament, and anything you need to cut flush to a surface. They are also useful to trim your 3D printed parts. Number three, tubing cutter. This simple Teflon tubing cutter provides a nice clean perpendicular cut because the tubing fits into this V groove perpendicular to the cutter. Number four, headlight. Many times you need both of your hands to perform a task, and this headlight allows you to see in difficult areas while at the same time freeing up your hands to hold your tools. Number five, needle nose pliers. These needle nose pliers are great for getting into tight spots and also helpful for removing supports from 3D models. Number six, screw gauges. These screw gauges are really helpful in quickly determining the length, diameter, and threads of screws. I have one for imperial and one for metric. These gauges also allow you to measure the diameter of holes. I also really like this 3D printed metric gauge for a quick check of a screw diameter and length of metric screws, especially because I normally use the imperial screws, so I'm not used to the metric sizes. A quick side note, I was visiting my friend in the emergency room of our hospital because he had kidney stones. I was talking to the nurse and she told me the good news is that my friend was going to pass the stone naturally because it was only 3 centimeters in diameter. I was trying to do the mental gymnastics in my head to visualize how large a kidney stone was, and I concluded it was the size of a golf ball. I immediately thought, my friend is more of a man than I am to be able to pass a kidney stone the size of a golf ball. I asked the nurse if she was sure it was 3 centimeters, and she realized she made a mistake and meant to say 3 millimeters. The nurse and I laughed and laughed. My friend wasn't laughing. He was more crying like a baby due to the extreme pain from that kidney stone. Anyway, I digress. Number seven. Low profile wrenches. This low profile wrench set is very useful because they get into places where normal wrenches can't fit. Number eight, adjustable wrench. I use this adjustable wrench all the time rather than tracking down my socket set. It's very versatile. Number nine, socket set. A low cost socket set that has both a metric and imperial sizes is one of the most versatile tools that you can own. Number 10, screwdrivers, both Phillips head and flat head. It's good to have a variety of screwdrivers, both Phillips head and flat head. There are also various tips that you can buy in a set that includes Torx and other heads. So the next section is number two, first layer adhesion, and the best way for your parts to stick to your build plate. If you're working on a prototype project and you need some help, I have the answer for you. This brings me to the sponsor of today's video, PCBWay. If you're working on any prototype projects, they can help you when you need a variety of parts. Besides making PCBs, they also offer CNC machining, sheet metal fabrication, injection molding, and lots of different types of 3D printing, including metal printing. You just need to go on the website, upload your design, select the material and quantity you need, and you'll get an instant quote. Then, they will manufacture the parts for you and ship them right to your door. Give them a try, and I think you will really be amazed what they can do for you. Check out PCBWay using the link below. Now, back to the show. So number 11 is isopropyl alcohol. I use isopropyl alcohol 70% by volume that I buy at my local drugstore. Some people recommend 99% by volume, but I haven't really seen a need for that. Number 12, paper towels, blue shop towels, or microfiber towels. I have used regular paper towels, blue shop towels, and microfiber towels to clean my build plates, and from my experience, they all have similar results. So it's really whatever you prefer. The nice thing about the microfiber towels is that you can wash them and reuse them. Number 13 is Dawn dish soap. This is a high quality soap that can remove fingerprints and oils from your build plate. I normally clean my build plates with the dish soap if cleaning with only isopropyl alcohol doesn't do the trick. Number 14, glue stick. I'm not a big fan of glue sticks because I think they are messy, but there have been times that the glue stick was what the doctor ordered to get my prints to stick to my build plate. Number 15, nanopolymer adhesive. I have found this to be a much better coating for build plates made by Vision Miner. I first heard about this coating from Stefan of CNC Kitchen. It's a bit pricey, but I have found this to be a miracle for getting prints to stick to some of my build plates. It was originally formulated to help with high temperature plastics such as PEEK and Ultem. However, they learned that it also works with TPU, PLA, PETG, ABS, PC, ASA, and others. So you really should consider trying it. The third section is general tools. Number 16 is, hey, how'd he get in there? Number 16, storage bins for filaments. I found these storage bins with gaskets are great for storing filaments. I just add some desiccant into the bins to keep the humidity down. Number 17, desiccant. Speaking of desiccant, I use the orange desiccant beads to change colors when they are saturated with moisture. So then I just throw them in the microwave to use them again. Let's go to our fourth section on tools, maintenance. Number 18, toothbrush cleaner for threaded rods. Occasionally, I'll get a reminder from my Bamboo Lab X1C to lubricate my threaded rods. This clever little 3D printed threaded rod cleaner uses a standard toothbrush to clean the old grease from your 3D printer. I just cut off the end of an old toothbrush, then I epoxied it to the 3D printed holder. I like this design because the bristles get deep into the grooves of the threaded rods instead of just using a paper towel. Also, using a toothbrush prevents cavities for your printer per the American Dental Association. Number 19, white lithium grease. I use this white lithium grease to lubricate my threaded rods of my 3D printers. This works really well. Number 20, a soldering iron. A small soldering iron is great for tinning wires, soldering wires, and making small repair to PCBs. By adding a special tip, it also can be used to add threaded inserts to your 3D printed parts, which I'll cover in the post-processing section. Number 21, facial tweezers. I like these facial tweezers because they are much stronger than these more delicate needle nose tweezers. If these facial tweezers are good enough for Aunt Ethel's facial hair, they are good enough to clean the molten plastic from my nozzles. Number 22, nozzle unclogging kit. Sooner or later, you will run into a clogged nozzle, and that's where this nozzle unclogging kit will come in really handy. This kit also includes some wrenches to be able to remove your nozzle from your printer. The fifth section is on measurement tools. So number 23, digital calipers. I use my digital calipers every day for a variety of things. Anytime I'm designing something in Fusion 360, I use my calipers to measure sizes of parts that I'm trying to design in the Fusion 360. I also use them to confirm dimensions of my 3D printed models. Number 24, a multimeter. A multimeter is invaluable for troubleshooting electrical circuits, including confirming continuity. I used my multimeter to confirm I had a defective power supply on one of my printers, and I was able to order a replacement on Amazon and had my printer up and running the next day. Number 25, temperature and humidity gauges. These little temperature and humidity gauges are very useful to monitor, especially moisture in my workshop, as well as inside my filament storage bins and my filament dry boxes. Number 26, torque wrench. This torque wrench set is great when you need to set a bolt or a screw to a specific torque setting. It has various tips for different designs of hardware. Number 27, a digital microscope. I wouldn't say a digital microscope is a must-have, but more of a nice-to-have tool. I recently purchased this to be able to inspect my 3D prints much more closely, as well as I'll be able to use this with my new laser cutter. I'm working on an extension so I can fit larger 3D prints under the microscope. The sixth section is on post-processing tools. Now, regarding safety, I'm not counting them as part of the 40 tools, but it's always important to use the proper safety protection, including safety glasses and dust protection. And if you're going to be using power equipment, hearing protection. Number 28, scraper. This is my subliminal message for you. Number 28, scraper. I've shown you this plastic scraper in previous videos. I love this thing because it has plastic disposable blades that don't scratch my build plates. And when the blades get nicked up, I just replace them. Number 29, drill bits, both imperial and metric. Many times, 3D printed holes aren't perfectly round, or they're undersized, so you need a nice metric or imperial set of drills, and they're perfect to fine-tune your prints. And you don't need this fancy pants Festo drill. A simple low-cost drill like this Black & Decker will do the trick. Number 30, a tap set, both metric and imperial. I've been designing in threads to many of my 3D printed parts. However, to make the threads work even better, I usually run a threaded tap to clean out the holes and cut more accurate threads. Number 31, deburring tool. A deburring tool is useful to remove brim material from your parts, but you have to be careful because I find that it tends to dig into the part, and then I have to add more force, which causes it then to slip. The important thing is to cut away from your body, not towards your hands. Number 32, a butane torch. There are several ways to clean up the edges and strings on your 3D printed parts. This butane torch works very well. However, since it is an open flame, you do have to be very careful of not melting your part and also not catching your surroundings on fire. Number 33, a heat gun. A more controlled heat source is a heat gun. This model has different tips and has a temperature adjustment from 50 degrees to 600 degrees C. This works well to remove strings and the white marks from the brims. This heat deflector shield works well with heat shrink tubing. Number 34, a heated X-Acto blade. The heated X-Acto blade allows you to cut plastic in a controlled way, and it also comes with several different tips. Number 35, files. To clean up your parts, a good set of files will quickly remove larger amounts of plastic before you go to the sanding step. Number 36, a sandpaper holder and also using a hacksaw blade cutter. I've used this sanding block for over 10 years. I took a standard sanding block and I glued a foam pad to it, which allows the block to conform to the shape of what I'm sanding. I made this sandpaper cutter from a simple piece of wood and an old hacksaw blade, and it works really well. Just slide the paper under and rip it right off. This is the same blade from 10 years ago. Number 37, sandpaper foam block. Another sanding option are these sandpaper foam blocks. They come in various grits. They're very flexible and washable, but eventually they'll lose their effectiveness and you'll just throw them out. Number 38, sandpaper strips and sticks. These sandpaper strips and sticks allow you to sand in very tight places that are very hard to reach. They also come in various grits. Number 39, 3D gloop. If you need to glue your 3D printed parts together, the best glue to use is 3D gloop. It literally fuses the plastic pieces together. If you've ever been to any of the Rep Wrap festivals, they'll glue two pieces of plastic together, and people will do a tug of war against their robot. The robot always wins, and the glue joint just doesn't fail. They make different glues for PLA, PET, and ABS/ASA. Number 40, a threaded insert machine. This threaded insert machine does a great job of being able to put threaded inserts to press fit them into your parts, and it makes sure the inserts are perpendicular to the holes. You can use just a regular soldering iron, but it's more of a challenge to keep them from going in crooked. My bonus item is a filament dryer. You could call it an accessory or a piece of equipment, but you will need to find some way to dry your filaments if they have absorbed too much moisture. On some printers, such as the Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, they have a setting that allows you to bake the filament to remove the moisture. There are several good filament dryers out there on the market, and in my next video, I will be reviewing two brands. So, did I miss any tools that you use? Please leave me a comment below. We are crossing the finish line of this tool review, so if you found this video useful, please consider hitting the like button and subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.